part of the buildup for the Bearcats and the Bulls. Last year's meeting, almost a year ago at this time, it was a crazy first quarter. Cincinnati puts 31 points on the board in the first quarter. It's a school record. Matt Grothy had four picks, one of them returned for a touchdown. But somehow, despite eight turnovers, the Bulls had a chance to win it at the end in the red zone. But a couple of passes fell incomplete, 38-33. Cincinnati scoreless after halftime. And Grothy, as we told you earlier, has had this game circled since those four turnovers via the air and a fumble. The Bearcats come out fired up. They were thumped in the second half by Connecticut on the road in a short week, but still very much alive in the Big East race. And this is what Brian Kelly wanted to see. These guys went all the way down, and I haven't seen this before, right to the student section.
You know what? Brian Kelly's been trying for a year and a half now to get the students and the fans in this city involved. His players understand the situation. They want to start fast tonight. Very important this football team comes out ready to go.
Now, based on the runout, you'd have to give the emotional edge to the Bearcats down to the field. For the touchdown, and the Bearcats cash in the pick for six. One-handed.
You see where Tony Pike throws this football? That's an unbelievable catch by Bengadooley, but Pike gives him a chance by throwing it to his outside shoulder, where only his receiver has a chance to come down with the football. Throw and an unbelievable catch. You're going to see Dominic Gibbon running the skinny post. He's got to get to an area of the field, and Tony Pike has to trust that he's going to get in that area.
Last chance for USF. Must convert this to have any chance. Grothy fires. Broken